native mobile applications. Apple, Google, and other manufacturers release cutting-edge phones every year. To make full use of these phones, you're going to need native applications. In this video, I'm going to run through what a native application is and its pros and cons, as well as a few other tips on building native applications. I'm Matt Grace, Managing Director of Flying Donkey. Let's get into it. Before I jump in the video, I want to thank you for watching this video today and ask you to please subscribe or like the video below. If you have anything else you'd like to learn about native applications or SaaS development in general, feel free to comment below and I'm happy to answer any of your questions. What is native app development? Native app development is where you're building a mobile application for one single phone operating system. Generally speaking, this is going to fall into one of two operating systems, either iOS or Android. Generally speaking, an Android app is going to use Java or Kotlin as one of its programming languages, and the Apple app is either going to use Objective-C or Swift. Generally speaking, native apps are known for their superior performance, including better user interaction with the device, as well as being able to utilize all of the latest facilities and technologies inside a phone. Because they run locally on the device, they have access to everything available to the device to run. From a customer's perspective, in order to get an app onto their phone, it's not going to really notice any difference between a native application or a hybrid application. Both these applications will get downloaded from the respective Play Stores and run directly on the end user's phone. Native applications have a plenty of pros and cons, and we're going to jump into these in this video. Hybrid versus native apps. If we have a quick look at what a hybrid app is, essentially it's a cross between a native application and a non-native application. In that, you have HTML and JavaScript running inside a native container, and it sometimes gives you the best of both worlds. A hybrid app is going to connect directly to your phone using an existing API set, and therefore it'll give you access to plenty of the devices, and therefore it'll give you plenty of access to the features that are needed on the device, such as things like the GPS or accelerometer. Here are some of the differences between a hybrid app and a native app. Number of code bases. Generally for a hybrid app, you're only going to have one code base. That's because it is interfacing directly with the container, and that container is abstracting away the differences between Android and iOS. Secondly, programming languages. Because you're in this abstracted layer, you can build this hybrid app in HTML and CSS, as well as JavaScript, which is obviously different from the native applications, which are generally either going to be in Java or Kotlin for Android, or Objective-C and Swift for iOS. Development costs. Generally speaking, a hybrid app is going to be cheaper than building a native application. And that's obviously because you're only going to build one hybrid application to work on multiple platforms. Obviously, we talked about having more than one code base. Essentially, this is going to cut down both your development time and your QA time, as well as simplifying the skill set you're going to need to deliver these applications. If you have an iOS and an Android app, you're going to need both an iOS and an Android development team, whereas having a hybrid app means you can have just a single team that looks after both operating systems. All right, we've had a look at hybrid app development. Let's have a quick look at cross-platform app development. Cross-platform app development differs slightly from hybrid apps because it's purely built as a standalone web technology. A number of the cross-platform application frameworks include Xamarin, Flutter, and React Native, and more we're seeing these popular frameworks be used for more and more applications. They're going to have similar pros and cons to the previous hybrid apps, but their abstraction is taken to the next level, where all of their code is essentially built as a web app. Therefore, you can share the development resource with your existing technology teams. I've talked more about cross-platform app development in a different video, and we'll link that one below in the description. All right, we've had a very quick look at a couple of alternatives to native app development. Let's dive into some of the pros for native app development. First and foremost, it is designed to be better performance. In the previous two examples with both hybrid and cross-platform apps, you have an abstraction layer between the application and the mobile itself. This obviously means that direct performance is going to be hindered. Having a native application that's going to interface directly with the mobile phone is going to give you the far superior performance. Now, this is not always noticeable to the human eye, nor is it notable to consumers in all cases. And that's why in a lot of cases, when companies weigh up whether they go down the hybrid, cross-platform, or native app space, they don't always go for that native app experience. But it is key to know that native app performance will outperform, in general, hybrid and cross-platform applications. Following UI and UX best practices. There's a number of great examples here, but building a native application is going to allow you to use all the tools that these manufacturers have given you. Pokemon Go was a revolution a couple of years ago. They used all the tools in its arsenal to produce an excellent gaming application that took the world by storm. Using both GPS, accelerometer, compass, and many other features of the phone, this meant that Pokemon Go needed to be developed as a native application. Easy to send notifications. Obviously, when you're building a native app, you have direct access to the phone and all of its capabilities and APIs. Sending notifications to users means you can piggyback on both systems in both Android and iOS, and therefore it's very easy for you as a developer to send notifications within the phone. Notifications are a huge part of applications, and being able to hook in to the native notification engine is sometimes a huge benefit of building native apps. Now, both hybrid and cross-platform apps can also hook into these native notifications, but they're not exactly the same. They obviously have an intermediary that's working in between them, so therefore the notifications, while end up almost being the same, can have some notable differences depending on how they're implemented. All right, so you want to build a native app. What are the native app tool sets that you can use? So for iOS, generally speaking, you're going to develop your application in a program called Xcode. As I mentioned, these programs are generally built within Objective-C or Swift, and the Xcode platform sits on top of the iOS SDK. This is a single integrated development environment produced by Apple to produce the best apps for the Apple iOS iPhone. Android. Android is a similar boat. Now, generally speaking, you're going to be using Android Studio to build your native app. It sits on top of the Android SDK, building in either Java or Kotlin. Again, this is a bit of an ecosystem that Google has put together to enable Android developers to build the best Android apps for their Android phones. I briefly mentioned an acronym there, the Software Development Kit, or SDK. This essentially is allowing all the functionality of the phones to be exposed into the developer. These SDKs are built custom by both Apple and Google and allow you to hook directly into their SDK and thus into their phones to drive native application development. Let's look at a few considerations for building a mobile app and how those relate back to a native app development. Firstly, speed to market. Generally speaking, if you're targeting both Android and iOS, building two native apps is going to take longer, and therefore we'd suggest either a hybrid or cross-platform app developed. But if you're only concentrating on one platform, generally speaking, building a native app is only going to take slightly longer, pending your technical skill available, than if you built in one of the other paradigms. Concentration of your audience. Where is your audience based, or if you're building an internal app for your company, what sort of phones does your company issue? If all your audience is on iOS, then you obviously want to build an iOS app. At this point, the savings of building both a hybrid or a cross-platform app start deteriorating, and if you want the best performance and the best outcome, building a native app is probably best for you. On the other hand, obviously, if your audience is split across both platforms, a native app may not be best for you, because you're really going to run into the trouble of duplicating your code and doubling up the effort. And that moves on to our final point here, cost. It's important to note that mobile apps are no small undertaking, and they do take quite a significant amount of cost to build. Not only is their initial build sometimes substantial, but their ongoing maintenance and updates also take significant time. It's important to note here, if you go out and try and build two native apps, you're going to have twice the amount of maintenance and cost to maintain them going forward. Again, if you want to have the best performance and the best outcome for your customers, then this might be the way you do it. But having said that, hybrid and both cross-platform apps can produce similar outcomes for a much reduced cost base. It's really just knowing where your audience is, what your budgets are, and what your time to market is when deciding on the best way to deliver your application. So again, to summarize that, when do you choose native application development? Well, there's really three key points you need to take in mind here. Firstly, you have the budget and you have top-notch resources available to you to produce the best app outcome you can. Therefore, native app development would be good for you. Secondly, you require extensive access to the hardware on each of the phone systems, including fingerprint scanners, GPS, accelerometers, compasses, etc. Now keep in mind that a lot of these are exposed into these hybrid and cross-platform apps. It's only some of the edge cases that you need to be careful of in order to access them via a native endpoint. And thirdly, you really want to produce a superior application which generally leads to more interactive graphics. Generally, games are always going to be built as native applications because they're so interactive and they need to use the GPU, whereas a B2B product or a B2C product, which is simply out there to take data and send it back to a web app, may not be the best use of your time to build a native app. So on the flip side, to summarize when to use a hybrid or cross-platform app, one, you don't have the in-house resources of a dedicated iOS or Android developer, but do have a technical team that potentially can put together another web app in the form of a cross-platform or hybrid app. You want to try and save costs while not always cutting down on performance. You have a very short development time that you need to hit, and therefore you really need to get to market quickly. A hybrid or cross-platform app will be perfect in this situation. And finally, generally, if you're doing any business-to-business or business-to-consumer app, or selling your app to a customer at the end of the day, in some sort of B2B or B2C play, then a cross-platform or hybrid app will be better for you. Whereas if you're obviously building a game, you're going to need to go down the native app route. So to summarize here, mobile apps are here to stay. Everyone uses their phone more and more, and more apps are being produced every day. When developing a native application, it's key to understand that yes, while they'll give you a superior outcome, you'll be able to use more of the device itself, they will cost more overall, they'll be unable to support more than one platform, and they will have a longer time to market. It's really about weighing up between these options, which way is the best to go. Here at Flying Donkey, we've built both native and cross-platform applications, and if you need any assistance in going forward with your mobile app development, feel free to get in touch.